Hey guys, it's Alex with Hammond Watch. I wanted to do a quick look video today. I love this. It's the SNKE53. Probably my favorite Seiko 5 watch outside of the Dress KX line. I think the proportions are phenomenal. But one thing that sucks is if you've ever seen these for sale and kind of flipped through and looked at all the measurements, they are always different. Like everywhere I look has a different set, and I wanted to do this so that you guys had just a real reference, you'd know the actual sizing, and also get a better idea of what the watch looks like in person, because in general, I don't think it photographs exceptionally well. This model, it's the SNKE53. The case size is 38.6 millimeters. Don't be afraid, you know, if you are comfortable in a 40 millimeter watch, this should still work for you. How wide this fixed bezel is and kind of the lug to lug help to give it a really strong footprint, so it wears just a little bit bigger than you might think. You have a really nice thickness at 10.5 millimeters. The crown, maybe slightly undersized at 4.5, is push-pull. You know, you're only getting 30 meters of water resistance, so certainly wouldn't use it for any type of water sports, but you know, rain, sweat, shower, shallow end of a pool, I think you're going to be pretty good otherwise. The lug tip to lug tip is a very nice 45.25. And in general, you know, that's relatively wide considering the width of the case. You know, I've seen Seiko dive watches that are sub 45 millimeters in lug to lug. So this ends up having a relatively nice chunky presence. I also see the lug width wrong all the time. It is 20 millimeters, not 18, I assure you. The bracelet itself tapers down to 18 millimeters, and then you're back up to 20 for the clasp. It's a two-button deployant, pressed metal. I mean, these are all folded links. I would not recommend the bracelet. You know, whenever I have these and are wearing them, I absolutely switch over to a leather strap, sometimes even like Cordura. In general, these watches are kind of basic, everyday styled, but they dress up really well and they dress down really well, so big fan. So the back of the watch does have a screw down case back. You see that there is also a piece of Hardlex crystal allowing you to see the 7S26 movement. That's an automatic movement with day and date functions. But being the 7S, it does not hack or hand wind. That just means that if your watch dies, you don't get the benefit of winding it through the crown. You kind of have to use movement to get everything going. Also, when you pull the crown all the way out for time setting, the seconds hand will continue to run. So you're not exactly going to be as precise as you might want to be. Although there are certainly some ways around that. Accuracy works right around, you know, minus 20 to plus 49. You know, in my experience, you're never really getting beyond about 20 seconds of variance, though. They also brag a 41-hour power reserve. I don't know that I've ever really tested that all the way. But in general, you know, I think, you know, 38 hours is probably that sweet spot of what you can really expect to get with the watch. So being a Seiko, the luminescence application, it is their proprietary LumaBright, which does last incredibly long and has a vibrant glow. But on these Seiko 5 watches, they tend to get a lesser application. So you can see them on the innermost tip of these indexes. And while they are visible and will last in the evening hours, it's not going to last through the night. There's simply not enough material to hold a charge and kind of have that long-lasting late-night visibility that you might be seeking. That said, it's not a dive watch, so I tend to give it a pass. So here we are on my 7.5 to 7 3/4 inch wrist, and I think the watch fits wonderfully. You know, it's got a really nice sizing, kind of reminiscent of the Hamilton khaki 38 millimeter. You know, it's small enough to fit under a cuff, but not so small that it feels feminine or dainty. And at the same time, it's got such a versatile dial. Again, you could go with a nice glossy like alligator skin strap, or you could put it on canvas and wear it very casually. It's going to work for most situations. So to provide just a little bit further insight, I wanted to do a quick side-by-side with the SKX just so you can really get an idea of the proportions. Like if you look at the lug-to-lug, the case width, you know, when we're talking a 38 millimeter versus a 43, they really feel like they're the same size. You know, they have very similar wrist presence, without the weight, of course. The SKX is a lot heftier of a timepiece. But I feel like some of these Seiko 5s seem undersized on paper, and when you get them in the flesh, it's really just not the case. So sizing aside, it's just a really handsome watch. I like that they incorporated so much polishing. I think it really steps the watch up, and it gives it a nice, shiny, rich luster. You have a glossy black dial with an applied Seiko and Seiko 5 logo. The indices are all fully polished, and then you have a nice framing around the date window. It's kind of frosted on the inner side while it's polished on the outermost surface. And the watch really just plays with the light well. You know, they didn't overdo it with text. You know, in general, if I had my way, I think I removed the 5 logo and 21 jewels. But those are really small nitpicks. You know, it's a very well put together piece. You know, the seconds hand being red adds a nice little pop of color. You know, you probably like to see that seconds hand be a couple millimeters longer so that it's reaching that track. But at the same time, given the price of these watches, that's a relatively small gripe. This watch retails for $250. I would never pay that. But if you start looking around on the gray market, you know, like Joma Shop and Amazon, you're going to find it for right around $100. If you're willing to go used, I pick these up on eBay pretty frequently for $50 to $70, kind of depending on condition. This one ran me right about $60, and I'm really pleased with the purchase. So, if you guys have enjoyed the video, please don't forget to give us a thumbs up. It helps out tremendously in YouTube's algorithm. Also, consider subscribing. I'm putting watch content out weekly, and hope to see you in the next one.